Welcome, welcome dear student. In a pharmaceutics first practical session, myself Mrs. Darshana Sandeep Shinde. Today, we deal with the experiment number 43. Title of our today's experiment is to prepare, evaluate and submit 10 ml of atropine sulfate eye drop. Learning outcomes of our today's session. After watching this video, students are able to develop the intellectual skills such as to understand the concept of ophthalmic manufacturing using the aseptic techniques, to understand the concept of sterile filtration, to understand the concept of terminal sterilization of eye drop. Then to develop the motor skills such as skill for measurement, skill for aseptic technique, sterile manufacturing, skill for sterile filtration, skill for terminal sterilization, skill for labeling of eye drops. Then we see the some concepts regarding this experiment. New concepts: atropine sulfate eye drops are prepared and terminally sterilized. Terminally sterilized means they are sterilized after filled into the final container. Then we see the theory regarding the ophthalmic preparations. What are the ophthalmic preparation? Ophthalmic preparation include the steroid solution or suspension intended for the topical drop wise installation in the eye, or a ointment for the topical application into the eye area. Let us see requirements for eye drops and or it may be eye ointment also. It should be sterile. It is free from foreign particle to avoid the irritation to the skin. It is neutral one. It should be isotonic with the lacrimal secretion. Our lacrimal secretion pH is almost 7.4. That's why it should be isotonic with our lacrimal secretion. Then we see the formulation of eye drops, medicament, then preservatives. This should be also applicable to the ointment also. Preservative, a suitable preservative like phenyl mercuric nitrate. Its concentration is 0.002 percentage weight by volume, or benzalkonium chloride 0.1% weight by volume, then chlorhexidine acetate 0.01% weight by volume may be used to prevent the bacterial or the fungal growth. Then antioxidants. Eye drop usually contain substance having the antiseptic, anti-inflammatory, anesthetic and the meiotic properties. When an active ingredient is susceptible to oxidative degradation, antioxidant may be added, but care should be taken to ensure compatibility between the antioxidant and other ingredient of the preparation. Then we see the next formulating agent, that is buffers. Ophthalmic preparation should be formulated at the pH equivalent to the tear fluid value of the 7.4. The buffer system selected should have a capacity adequate to maintain the pH between the stability range for the duration of the product shelf life. Also, it should not cause the stinging or discomfort on the installation. Example of its for the eye purpose, phosphate buffers are preferred. Then tonicity contributors. Tonicity refers to the osmotic pressure exerted by the salt in an aqueous solution. An ophthalmic solution is isotonic when its tonicity equal to that of the 0.9% W by V sodium chloride. NaCl 0.9%, it is said to be the isotonic with our blood plasma. Then viscosity contributors. Ophthalmic solution and suspension may contain the viscosity imparting polymer to thicken the tear film and increase the corneal contact time. That is to reduce the rate of the tear fluid drainage. For suspension, the increased viscosity also serves to reduce the settling particle between the use and at the same time maintain their suspension for uniform dosage. Example of its methyl cellulose, hydroxypropyl cellulose, hydroxypropyl methyl cellulose, hydroxyethyl cellulose and polyvinyl cellulose. That means viscosity contributors, they are increase the viscosity now in case of the suspensions to get increase the contact time with the cornea. Then we see the containers required for the eye drops. Eye drops are packed in a vertically fluted bottle made up of the neutral glass container or a plastic container. The bottles are fitted with the backlight cap carrying a dropper. The bottle made up of neutral glass must be conform alkalinity limit test. Then bottle must not impart particle to contain, and the closure should not be absorb active constituent or preservative added to the eye drops. Then we see the eye drops sterilized by following method. Amongst that, if we sterilize or if we prepare the eye ointment should be filled in the tube, collapsible tube, or for the easy installation into the eye. Then eye drops are sterilized by apparatus use must be sterile, and filling in a final container is carried out aseptically. First method for the sterilization is sterilization carried out by the filtration by using the aseptic transfer. Then method is carried out. Second method, sterilization is carried out in a container, final container, and autoclave it for 121 degrees Celsius for 20 minutes at the 15 lbs pressure. And method 3 is the 98 to 100 degrees Celsius for the 30 minutes in a final container along with the one substance, any other preservative specified in the individual monograph. These are the three methods which are used for the sterilization of the eye drops. Eye ointment is sterilized in the hot air oven. For that purpose, we use the hot air oven. Then we see the labeling. Label should contain name of the drug, name and concentration of preservatives. Warning should be given, just like open the words for external use only should be added on the label. And in addition to this, following instruction should be appear on the label, like use within 1 month after opening. Do not touch the tip of the dropper. If irritation persists, discontinue the use and consult the physician. All these labels should be must on the our final containers label. Then we see the apparatus required for today's experiment: conical flask, volumetric cylinder, spatula, beaker, sintered glass filter, face mask, gloves and vials, rubber closure, autoclave for the sterilization. Then we see the formulation table. Formulation table contained the ingredients, quantity given, taken, use of the ingredients. Ingredients are atropine sulfate IP, which is required 1 gram for 100 ml, phenyl mercuric nitrate 0.002 gram for 100 ml, distilled water quantity sufficient to produce 100 ml. But today we have to prepare only the 10 ml. So that our required factor can be calculated by the quantity required upon quantity given. Quantity required is 10, quantity given 100, after our factor is 0.1. By this 0.1 factor, we can multiply all the quantities of the quantity given. We ultimately get the quantity taken. For an example, 0.1 multiplied by 0.01, we get the 0.1 in this way. Atropine sulfate is used as a parasympatholytic and or anticholinergic drug. Phenyl mercuric nitrate is used as a preservative and distilled water as a vehicle. Then we see the stepwise procedure. Atropine sulfate ophthalmic solution is a sterile aqueous solution, contain 1% wet by volume of atropine sulfate and 0.002% of wet by volume of phenyl mercuric nitrate. The pH of the preparation should be between 3.5 and the 6. Atropine sulfate is a stable in the acidic pH. If the pH is more than 6, the drug hydrolyzes and atropine base is precipitated, causing the turbidity in the solution or in the atropine. Atropine form may be further hydrolyzed and degraded. So, pH maintenance is important. Dilute sulfuric acid is added to adjust the pH of the preparation between 3.5 and the 6, because atropine sulfate is stable in an acidic medium. The pH cannot be lower than 3.5 because the preparation then may cause the eye irritation and damage to the cornea. Atropine sulfate is a parasympatholytic and it is used prior to ophthalmic examination or the ophthalmic surgery. First of all, dissolve the atropine sulfate in 3/4 volume of the preparation using distilled water. That means we have to dissolve 3 to 4 ml of distilled water, required quantity of atropine sulfate. Then adjust the pH between 3.5 and 5 by using the dilute sulfuric acid. Make up the volume required. Filter the solution through the sintered glass filter. The solution is sterilized by heating in autoclave or by filtration. Category of our today's preparation is parasympatholytic or anticholinergic. Storage, store in a cool place protected from the light. Label should be not for ingestion, for external use only. And warning should be written on the label, like if irritation persists or increase, discontinue the use and consult to the physician. Use within the 1 month after opening the container. Do not touch the dropper tip or other dispensing tip to any other surface as it may be contaminate the solution. Then we move toward the laboratory for practical session. Welcome dear students in the pharmaceutics first laboratory session. In this session we prepare the atropine sulfate eye drop. Today we prepare the 10 ml of eye drop. In our manual the formula is given for the 100 ml of atropine sulfate eye drop. Atropine sulfate eye drop is a parasympatholytic drug. For that we have to require the chemicals. Atropine sulfate, we take a major quantity of that. Phenyl mercuric nitrate, which is used as a preservative. This is a purified water. And this is the sulfuric acid to maintain the pH. pH maintaining, we use the sulfuric acid. And this is the pH paper. And this is our final container. We wear the mask. We use all the aseptic techniques and then do the practicals. Let's start the practical procedure. Take a beaker. In that we take 3 to 4/4 volume of distilled water, pour it into it. Then dissolve atropine into it. Add atropine. It properly. Add this preservative, that is phenyl mercuric nitrate, into this. Again stir it. And here we use this sulfuric acid, dilute sulfuric acid, to for maintaining the pH. Add dilute sulfuric acid into it and adjust the pH. Adjust the pH between 3 to 5. We measure this solution. See. Its pH is nearer to 5, that means between 3 to 5. Then we add required amount of distilled water into it and make it final volume. We first of all add around 4 ml, then we add next 4.5 ml of distilled water. That means our quantity is almost 10 ml. We make up the volume. We make a final volume 10 ml. And after that, we filter it through the center glass filter. Then we filter the solution through the center glass filter. This is center glass filter assembly. We have to pour the solution over that. And we start the filtering assembly. Now filtration is over. Then pour this into the beaker. And we finally fill. Before filling, we have to autoclave, or we have to sterilize by autoclaving or by the filtration, but we prefer the autoclaving. Then we sterilize this eye drop to the autoclaving. Pour the solution into the final container. Then seal the container and kept it into the autoclave for autoclaving. This is the lid. We have to pour this lid over on it. Fix the screw. After 20 minutes, we autoclaving start. That means we have to take a time of 20 minutes. It maintain almost 15 lb pressure. After that, we will remove our solution, or we will remove our eye drops final container from the autoclave. After heating with 20 minutes and cooling the autoclave almost 30 minutes, we remove our solution with the help of the cotton or cloth. In this way, our solution gets sterile. Eye drop of our atropine sulfate gets prepared here. Now for the evaluation and the labeling, we move towards the next session. After go through the stepwise procedure into the laboratory, we move toward the observation and evaluation table. Observation and evaluation table contain the name of the preparation, test, specification and observation. Name of our preparation is atropine sulfate eye drop IP. Test description, our preparation is clear one, we confirm that test. Odor is odorless, we confirm that test. Particles, there are no particles in that, we confirm that test. We filtered through the center glass filter. pH is between, we maintain the pH between 3 to 5.5. That means we confirm all the evaluation test. Then we see the labeling. Label of our preparation should be such that at the top side we should mention the name of our preparation and at the right hand side its quantity. Name of our preparation, atropine sulfate eye drop IP and 10 ml quantity. Then we mention the each 10 ml content or each 1 ml. Here we mention each 10 ml content. All the ingredients should be mentioned. Then category of today's preparation, that is parasympatholytic. Then general direction, not for ingestion and for external use only. Then the warnings, use within the 1 month after opening. Do not touch the tip of the dropper. If irritation persists, discontinue the use and consult the physician. Then storage condition. Store in a cool place protected from the light. Then manufacturing details such as the manufacturing license number, manufacturing batch number, expiry date, then manufacturing date, etc. And at the bottom, name and address of the manufacturer. Then we move toward the result. Result should be written as 10 ml of atropine sulfate eye drop IP submitted in a well-closed container with the neat label. Then we move toward the question answer session. First question is, state the requirements of ophthalmic preparation. Requirements for eye drops or ophthalmic preparations are, it should be sterile, it should be free from foreign particles to avoid the irritation to eye. It should be neutral one. It should have, or it should be isotonic with the lacrimal secretion. These are the requirements. Then next question is, what are the different terminal sterilization process used for the ophthalmics? There are a number of terminal sterilization process. Amongst that, moist heat sterilization, radiation sterilization, gaseous sterilization, dry heat sterilization are used for the sterilization of the ophthalmic. Amongst that, moist heat sterilization is preferred one. All over that. Then give the formulation for ophthalmic preparation. In the ophthalmic preparation, we add a medicament, preservative, antioxidants, buffers, tonicity contributors, viscosity contributors. Then next question is, why it is necessary to maintain the pH between 3 to 5.5? Answer is, the pH of the preparation should be between 3.5 and the 6 because atropine sulfate is stable in the acidic pH. If the pH is more than the 6, the drug hydrolyzes and atropine base is precipitated, causing the turbidity in the solution. Or atropine form may be further hydrolyzed and it is degraded. That's why pH between 3 to 5.5 is maintained. Then next question is, write the labeling requirements for the ophthalmic preparation. Label should contain name of the drug, name and concentration of the preservative, warning. Warning should contain the words for external use only. It added on the label. In addition, following instructions should be appear on the label, like use one within the 1 month after opening. Do not touch tip of the dropper. If irritation persists, discontinue the use and consult to the physician. And the next question is, name the different preservative use and concentration in which they are used in the ophthalmic preparation. These are the benzalkonium chloride from 0.01 to 0.002 concentration, phenyl mercuric acetate or phenyl mercuric nitrate in the concentration of 0.1 or 0.02 also, then thiomersal chlorhexidine acetate 0.01%. Then next question is, state the porosity of different membrane filters. The membrane filter contain the pore ranging from 0.1 to 10 micrometer for the microfiltration and 0.001 to 0.1 micrometer for the ultrafiltration. What do you mean by the next question is, what do you mean by the term parasympatholytic? The answer is, parasympatholytic agent is a substance or activity that reduces the activity of the sympathetic nervous system. Parasympathetic nervous system is often colloquially described or collaterally described as the feed and breed or rest and digest portion of the autonomic nervous system. Thank you very much for attending my practical session.